Want to speak real German from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at germanpod101.com.
Hallo?
Hello.
Hallo?
Hello?
It's usually used between friends, and usually you add hallo, wie geht's? It's hello, how are you?
Guten Morgen.
Good morning.
Guten Morgen.
Good morning.
And obviously it's used in the
very casual would be just morning,
morgen.
Guten Tag,
good afternoon.
Guten Tag means good afternoon or good day.
You don't usually say it to friends.
Guten Tag.
Na klar,
of course.
Na klar means of course. I actually use it a lot.
It's very casual. Kannst du mein Auto heute waschen? Na klar.
That would be really good. But it means, can you wash my car today?
Of course. Who wouldn't want that, right?
Wie heißen Sie?
What's your name?
Wie heißen Sie means, what's your name?
Wie heißen Sie is a very formal way to say it.
Between friends, it would be more, wie heißt du?
Wie heißen Sie?
Ich heiße Alisa.
What's your name? My name is Alisa.
Ich bin,
I am.
Ich bin heute gut drauf.
I am in a really good mood today.
Ich bin im Urlaub.
I am on vacation.
Wie geht es Ihnen?
How are you?
Wie geht es Ihnen?
And then, mir geht es gut.
How are you?
I am good.
Es freut mich, Sie kennenzulernen.
Nice to meet you.
Hallo, wie geht's?
Es freut mich, Sie kennenzulernen.
Hello, how are you?
Nice to meet you
is a very common sentence.
Mir geht es gut, danke.
Und Ihnen?
I'm fine, thanks.
And you?
Mir geht es gut, danke. Und Ihnen?
I'm fine, thanks.
And you?
It's the answer to if you get asked, wie geht es Ihnen?
So when you're talking to friends, you can actually say, mir geht es gut, danke. Und dir?
Bitte, please.
Bitte also means you're welcome.
Danke, dass du heute einkaufen warst.
Ach, bitte.
Thank you for going grocery shopping today.
You're welcome.
Bis später.
See you later.
Bis später.
See you later.
Bis gleich means when you're actually meeting in maybe 5 to 10 minutes. And bis später is used mostly, for example, in the morning and you're going to meet during the evening.
Hallo, sollen wir heute essen gehen?
Ja, gerne.
Ja, dann bis später.
Hello, should we go have something to eat today?
Yes, sure.
See you later.
Ich glaube schon.
I think so.
Ich glaube schon.
I think so.
Meinst du, wir können heute was trinken gehen?
Ich glaube schon.
Do you think we can go have drinks tonight?
I think so.
Ich glaube schon is kind of like an uncertain thing to say.
Danke.
Thank you.
Danke.
Thank you.
Danke is a very casual between friends and family.
Wie geht es dir heute?
Danke, sehr gut.
How are you today?
Thank you.
I am fine.
Gern geschehen.
You're welcome.
Ja, danke, dass du mir beim Umzug geholfen hast.
Gern geschehen.
Thank you for helping me move.
You're welcome.
Ja.
Yes.
Ja means yes. And of course, it's a very, very common word in German.
You use it all the time when you're listening to someone.
Ja.
Gehst du heute, kannst du heute bitte mit dem Hund spazieren gehen?
Ja.
Can you take the dog for a walk today?
Yes.
Nein.
No.
Nein.
No.
Hast du am Samstag Zeit?
Nein, leider nicht.
Are you free on Saturday?
No, sorry, I'm not. Just saying nein is a little bit rude, so people just add, no, I'm not free. Okay, okay. It's more used with friends and family and not at workplace. When I was a child, I wasn't allowed to say okay, for example. I have to say yes or no. Ja, nein. And of course, okay is also used, for example, wie geht es dir? Or mir geht's okay. And how are you? I'm okay. Kannst du mir vielleicht eine Kamera heute ausleihen? Okay. Could you lend me your camera today? Okay. Entschuldigung. Excuse me. Entschuldigung. Excuse me. Entschuldigung, Sie haben gerade Ihre Schlüssel verloren. Excuse me, you just dropped your keys. So yeah, excuse me and I'm sorry means both. Entschuldigung. It's a very formal way to ask somebody for a favor. Kein Problem. No problem. Kein Problem. No problem. It's a very common sentence. I use it all the time. Kein Problem. Kein Problem. Kein Problem. If somebody's gonna be late or, ich komme erst in 10 Minuten. KP means no problem. Wie viel Uhr ist es? What time is it? Yes, obviously, when you wanna know the time, you ask this and it's used at work. It's neither formal or casual. You can use it with friends. You're in the city and you forgot your watch. Entschuldigen Sie, wie viel Uhr ist es? Excuse me, what time is it? It's a very common phrase and used everywhere. Einen Moment bitte. One moment, please. You bought something and you want to return it. Entschuldigen Sie, ich würde gerne etwas zurückschicken. Einen Moment, bitte. Excuse me, I would like to return something. One moment, please. Ich hätte gerne, I would like. Ich hätte gerne einen Salat mit Pommes. I would like a salad with fries. Wait. I would like a water. Wie viel macht das? How much is it? Ich hätte gerne ein Kleid für eine Hochzeit. Wie viel macht das? I would like a dress for a wedding. How much is it? Zahlen bitte. The check, please. Zahlen bitte. The check, please. When you're ordering something and you're finished and you want to pay, you usually say to the waiter or waitress, zahlen bitte. Hilfe, help. Hilfe! Help! Hilfe, like help, is when you're in need of something or you can't do it by yourself. You scream or you say, Hilfe! Ja, ich bräuchte Hilfe heute Abend. I need help tonight. Aufgeregt, excited. Aufgeregt, excited. Ich bin aufgeregt, jetzt mit euch dieses Video zu drehen. I am excited to film this video. Dynamisch, energetic. Dynamisch, energetic. Ich versuche jeden Tag mein Tag sehr dynamisch zu starten. I try to start my day very energetic. I wake up with a big smile. That makes a big difference if you try. You know, most people are not morning people, but I think if you start the day with a smile, then it will be a good day. Entspannt, relaxed. Entspannt, relaxed. Normalerweise ist der Sonntag mein Tag, wo ich entspanne. Usually Sundays is the day I relax. Maybe it's a very German thing, but Sundays is in Germany a kind of a holy day for family to relax and just be with friends and not think about work or just anything. Freundlich, kind. Freundlich, kind. Meine Nachbarin ist sehr freundlich. My neighbor is very kind. Yeah, I think when you get along, especially with neighbors, that's very nice. And sometimes, you know, if you need something, you can just ring the bell and ask for certain things. So it's always good to be a kind neighbor. Remember that. Glücklich, happy. Glücklich, happy. Jeden Tag sollte man glücklich verbringen. Every day should be a happy day. Well, yeah, some of you who have been following my videos maybe know that usually I'm very happy. It actually takes a lot for me not to be happy. So, yeah, I think it's very positive and good for yourself to always be happy and learn German happily. Hoffnungsvoll, hopeful. Hoffnungsvoll, hopeful. Ich bin hoffnungsvoll, dass mein nächster Urlaub sehr gut sein wird. I am hopeful that my next summer vacation will be very good. I think we all look forward to our summer vacations and yeah, let me know what you have planned. Lachen, to laugh. Lachen, to laugh. Lachen ist ansteckend. To laugh is contagious. I think to laugh is a universal language and it just is a good way to start a conversation, or if you're new somewhere or in a country where you don't know, it's a good way to start and even learn a language by laughing. Lieben, to love. Lieben, to love. Ich liebe Hunde. I love dogs. Yes, I am a dog lover. And well, if you've been following some of my other videos, I actually, my parents actually own a German Shepherd, and he's really sweet, and I really love him. And dogs are just very kind animals. Lustig, funny. Lustig, funny. Ich liebe lustige Filme. I love funny movies. Well, comedies, funny movies are such a good way to spend, for example, a Sunday afternoon. Mögen, to like. Mögen, to like. Was mögt ihr an der deutschen Sprache? What do you like most about the German language? Leave in the comments. I would love to know. Der Name. Name. The plural version is die Namen. Mein Name ist Alisa. My name is Alisa. Mein Spitzname ist Lieschen. My nickname is Lieschen. Die Uhrzeit. Time of day. Wie viel Uhr ist es? Die Uhrzeit ist 11 Uhr. Der Mann. Man. Die Männer. Men. Die typischen deutschen Männer sind groß und blond. The typical German men are tall and blond. Die Frau, woman. Die Frauen, women. Die deutschen Frauen sind starke Frauen. The German women are tough women. Die Person, person. Die Personen, people. Die Personen in Deutschland sind sehr freundlich. The people in Germany are friendly. Die Sache, thing. Die Sachen, things. So, Sache, die Sache is more used in written German language. Die Sachen in meinem Zimmer sehen chaotisch aus. The things in my room look chaotic. Die Sache is a very formal way of saying thing. So, das Ding, die Dinge, is a very casual way of saying thing. I actually use it a lot for everything. Die Mutter, mother. Die Mütter, mothers. Einige meiner Freundinnen sind schon Mütter. A few of my friends are already mothers. Der Tag, day. Die Tage, days. Mein Tag hat heute sehr früh angefangen. My day started very early today. Regnerische Tage. Rainy days. Der Moment. Moment. Die Momente. Moments. Was war dein schönster Moment? What was your most special moment? Die Momente im Leben. The moments in life. Der Vater. Father. Die Väter. Fathers. Mein Vater ist Deutsch. My father is German. Die Väter in Deutschland lieben es, Bier zu trinken. Fathers in Germany love to drink beer. I'm sure not only Germany, but... Der Bruder, brother, die Brüder, brothers. Ich habe einen Bruder. I have one brother. Die Freizeit, free time or leisure time. In meiner Freizeit unternehme ich gerne etwas draußen. In my free time I like to be outside. Die Tochter, daughter, die Töchter, daughters. Ich bin eine komplizierte Tochter. I am a complicated daughter, I think, to my mother. Der Sohn, son, die Söhne, sons. Der nette Sohn von nebenan. The nice son from next door. Das Kind, child, die Kinder, children. Ich bin immer noch sehr oft Kind. I am still a lot of times a child. Die Kinder in Deutschland spielen gerne draußen. The children in Germany like to play outside. Das Wort, word. Die Wörter, words. Du wirst jetzt 25 Wörter lernen. You will learn 25 words. Der Kopf, head. Die Köpfe, heads. Okay, so der rollende Kopf, the rolling head. In German, if you do something bad, it's a way of saying die rollenden Köpfe or your heads will roll. It's the same saying as in German, die rollenden Köpfe. Die lustigen Köpfe der Klasse, the funny heads in the classroom. There are always some class clowns. In Germany we call them die lustigen Köpfe der Klasse. Der Freund, friend. Die Freunde, friends. In German could mean my friend or also my boyfriend. Meine Freunde sind super. My friends are awesome. Oh, ist das dein Freund, Freund oder Freund? So, Freund, Freund means, is that your boyfriend or is it just a friend? Die Schwester, sister. Die Schwestern, sisters. Viele meiner Freundinnen sind wie Schwestern. A lot of my friends are like sisters to me. Die Arbeit, work. Die Arbeiten, work, as in a plural version. Was ist deine Arbeit? What is your work? Die Woche, week. Die Wochen, weeks. Meine Woche hat sehr gut angefangen. My week started very well. Die kommenden Wochen werden heiß. The next weeks are going to be hot. Der Monat, month. Die Monate, months. Mein Geburtstagsmonat ist Januar. My birthday month is January. Was sind deine Lieblingsmonate? What are your favorite months? Das Jahr, year. Die Jahre, years. Welches Jahr ist dein Geburtsjahr?
What year is your birth year? Die letzten Jahre vergingen sehr schnell. The last years went by fast. Das Zuhause, home. Ich fühle mich an verschiedenen Orten zu Hause. I feel home in different kind of places. Die Nummer, number. Die Nummern, numbers. Das ist die Nummer 25 dieser Lektion. This is number 25 of this lesson.
Verärgert, upset. Verärgert, upset. Der Mann ist sehr verärgert, weil er noch viel Arbeit zu erledigen hat. The man is upset as he has a lot of work remaining. I mean, okay, it's very annoying if you have a lot of work still left to do. But others, they love work. They're like, oh yes, I have more work to do. It depends on how you look at it, if you like your work or not. It can be upsetting, but it can be cool. So yeah, I guess most people are just like, damn, more work. Verletzen, to hurt. Verletzen, to hurt. Es tut mir leid, dass ich deine Gefühle verletzt habe. I'm sorry I hurt your feelings. To be hurt can be in several ways. It can be hurt of feelings, as in my example sentence. You can also be hurt, as for example in sports. Then we would also say verletzt. For example, an injured player in a soccer game, he is verletzt. So it counts both, like feelings, sports, physically as mentally. You can be hurt. Einsam. Lonely. Einsam. Lonely. Die Frau ist einsam. The woman is lonely. Yeah, when I hear this, I always remember this one song of a couple of years ago. Lonely, I'm so lonely. Yeah, I'm not so good at singing, so I should stop that. I don't like to be lonely. I prefer being around people. I guess that's what's most. But again, as I said in the first example word of being upset of too much work, being lonely can be cool for some people. A lot of people prefer to have time on their own for most of it and just sometimes hang out with more people. Others, me including, like to be around people all the time and then just sometimes step back and have time for themselves. Like, how are you? If you want to share like your feelings about any of these words, please just do it below in the comments, okay? Traurig, sad. Traurig, sad. Er war traurig und seufzte. He was sad and sighed. Do you even pronounce it sigh? I'm not exactly sure. It's a sound of huh. Like if I'm sad, huh. Like in German, seufzte. Er war traurig und seufzte. He was sad and sighed. I hope I pronounced that right. Yeah, some people overdo it if they just really want to make clear, like, hey, I'm sad, please take care of me. Like, huh. Elend. Miserable. Oh, it's getting even better. Now we have number 5. Elend. Miserable. Heute fühle ich mich richtig elend. Today, I feel really miserable. Oh gosh, I mean, miserable. Yeah, that's all. Again, this counts for both psychologic as physiologic. For example, if you ate something really bad last day, you can feel miserable. But you can also feel miserable because you did something stupid the other day. Or because, I don't know, you have a crush and he's not really into you, so that can make you feel miserable. Yeah, feeling miserable. Elend, there are many ways to do that. I hope you haven't experienced too much of it, at least not too often. Entmutigt, discouraged. Entmutigt, discouraged. Er fühlte sich ziemlich entmutigt nach seiner Niederlage. After his defeat, he felt very discouraged. When you lose, so you're like, oh gosh, I put it so much focus on this, this meant so much to me and it didn't work out, so I'm discouraged. Entmutigt, enttäuscht. Disappointed. Enttäuscht. Disappointed. Er wurde von seiner Frau enttäuscht. He was disappointed by his wife. I hope that wife didn't do something too bad. Yeah, disappointed. Like, it can be something really minor, like, oh, I came home and I hoped she, I don't know, prepared maybe a nice little lunch or something. Then, oh no, so I'm a little bit disappointed. You shouldn't be, because it's not the task of your wife to cook food, right? It can be something minor, like, oh, I hope you took a picture of that car and you didn't, so I'm a little bit disappointed, enttäuscht. It can also be something super big, like, oh, wow, you cheated on me, I'm very disappointed. And I hope that didn't happen to any of you. Bad feeling. Didn't happen to me, luckily. I mean, I guess. Who knows? I guess I have never been cheated on. Knock on wood, right? Sich sorgen, to worry. Sich sorgen, to worry. Die Frau sorgt sich um die Rechnung. The woman worries about the bill. If you worry about money, that really sucks, because mostly you cannot really do so much about it. Even worse, for example, if you worry about your kids, like, oh, my kids go to school and they don't come back, they should be here already, then this is super, like, frightening and you worry. Man sorgt sich. If I'm a parent, I worry about my child. Ich sorge mich um mein Kind. Try not to worry so much about what might happen or might not happen, as long as you cannot really influence it anyways. Besorgt. Anxious. Besorgt. Anxious. Die Klausurergebnisse werden morgen bekannt geben und ich bin sehr besorgt darüber. The exam results will be announced tomorrow and I'm very anxious about it. Yeah, I remember when I had my A-levels in school, like here we call it Abitur, like our final exams from school. There were some subjects I was like anxious about because I actually tried to study a lot as much as I could. But then some just really didn't work out so well, I had the feeling, so I was like anxious. After all, don't worry about me, I'm fine, I passed, I could go to university, to college. But yeah, I think as everybody of us went to school, we know the feeling of being anxious about some exam results coming out. Düster, gloomy. Düster, gloomy. Nachts, es ist draußen düster. It is gloomy outside in the night. Yeah, actually, for me, this is not such a sad word in this example phrase, because I like kind of like the gloomy night sighting. But for example, if you're a gloomy person, that's kind of negative. You feel like always, like, oh, this is going to be so bad. Like, I can see the future. It's, everything is going down. Like, that's very gloomy. Yeah, there's no reason to be gloomy, I guess. We live in a pretty cool world, even though there's a lot of trouble everywhere. Also, gloomy, it makes me remember this one last Rolling Stones song they came up with, Doom and Gloom. It has nothing really to do with this lesson, I just wanted to bring it up, because it's a great band.
Gut. Good. Heute bin ich gut drauf. Today I am in a good mood. Die guten alten Zeiten, the good old days. Neu, new. So depending on the article, the adjective changes in German as well. Das neue Mädchen in der Klasse. The new girl in class. Der neue Hund meiner Nachbarin. The new dog of my neighbors. Erste, first. Ich war noch nie Fallschirmspringen, also würde ich es sehr gerne ausprobieren und es wäre mein erstes Mal. I've never gone skydiving before, so it would be my first time and that's exciting. Letzte, last. Ich war das letzte Mal am Meer vor circa einem Jahr. The last time I was at the ocean was about 1 year ago. Lecker, tasty. Ich liebe leckeres Essen. Wer nicht? I love tasty food. Who doesn't? Ich finde scharfes Essen sehr lecker. I think spicy food is very tasty. Krank, ill. Ich war letztens 10 Tage krank. I was ill for 10 days, actually. Klein, little. Ich finde kleine Hunde süß. I think little dogs are cute. Laut, loud. Das Stadtleben ist laut. The city life is loud. Die laute Musik, the loud music. Groß, big. Mein Hund ist ziemlich groß. My dog is pretty big. Andere, other. So it is singular and plural. Ich habe lustige Freunde, aber auch andere Freunde. I have funny friends, but also other friends. Wer ist die andere Person? Who is that other person? Yep. Alt, old. Ich mag alte Schätze. I love old treasures. Ich mag alte Omas, die sind sehr süß. I like old grandmas, they're really cute. Kalt, cold. Ich mag es überhaupt nicht, wenn es kalt ist. I don't like it at all when it's cold. Müde, tired.
Ja, heute bin ich etwas müde. Ich hoffe, ihr seht das nicht. Today I'm a little tired. I hope you don't see it. Gut gelaunt. Cheerful. Ich bin meistens gut gelaunt oder versuche, alles gut gelaunt zu sehen. I am most of the times cheerful and I try to see everything as cheerful. Verrückt, crazy. Ich glaube, einige Leute denken, ich bin verrückt. I think a lot of people actually think I'm crazy and I love it. Ich finde, mit den besten Freunden kannst du immer verrückt sein. I think with your best friends you can always be crazy. Those are the best ones. Lustig, funny. Finde mich immer sehr lustig. Vielleicht andere nicht, aber ich. I think I'm funny, even though maybe other people don't, but I think so. Einer meiner lieblingslustigen Schauspieler ist Ben Stiller. One of the most funniest actors is Ben Stiller. Schön, pretty, das schöne Mädchen, the pretty girl, or der schöne Sonnenuntergang, the pretty sunset. Schwierig, difficult. Ich fand Mathematik immer sehr schwierig. Always thought math was very difficult. Heiß, hot. Das Essen ist heiß. The food is hot. Or you can say also hot as in the weather is hot. Wichtig, important. Ich finde, das Wichtigste ist, sich selber treu zu bleiben. I think the most important thing is to be true to yourself. Interessant, interesting. Ich finde Kunst sehr interessant. I think art is very interesting. Es gibt auch viele interessante Personen. There are a lot of interesting people. Super, great. Das Essen war heute super. The food was great today. Eine super Erfahrung war für mich, als ich tauchen war in Ägypten. One of the most greatest experiences for me was to dive in Egypt. Schlecht, bad. Das schlechte Wetter would be the bad weather. So there's an E again, depending on the article. Das schlechte Essen, the bad food. Langweilig, boring. Mir ist nie langweilig. Ich finde immer etwas. I am actually never bored. I always find something to do or funny. And weit, far. Ich liebe es, weit weg zu reisen. I love to travel to faraway places. Die Strecke von meinem Haus zur Arbeit ist weit. The way from my house to work is far.
Rucksack, Backpack. Er trug seine Bücher, Stifte und Papiere im Rucksack. He carried his books, pencils and papers in the backpack. Yeah. See, I have still my backpack from my time at school. I used to have it since fifth grade, I think. To be really cool, I put it this Rolling Stones tong here. Yeah, you can see it already survived many years. Kind of broken by now. But it did a good job. Rolling Stones. Klassenkamerad. Classmate. Sarah war meine Klassenkameradin in der Schule. Sarah was my classmate at school. I think that classmates are the most important in all the school time, because, I mean, of course, all the stuff you learn, but you will never get that much time with all your friends and your classmates, like, later on when you work. It's difficult to keep in touch, so if you're still in school or at college, appreciate having all your friends around you all the time. Unfortunately, this will not last forever. Hausaufgaben. Homework. Ich mache jeden Tag nach der Schule Hausaufgaben. I do homework every day after school. Yeah, right. I wouldn't do them before class. Of course, most of the homework is to be done at home, but I think all of you know that from time to time, little things are just done right in time before class. Prüfung. Exam. Ich muss für meine Prüfung lernen. I must study for my exam. Yeah, this is probably one of the parts people don't miss so much about time at school or in college. The exam period. It's very stressful always. Study a lot, but come on, most people survived. Next one. Notizheft. Notebook. Ich habe für jeden Kurs ein eigenes Notizheft. I have a separate notebook for each class. Looking here in my school bag, yeah, there is like a notebook. And let's see. It's even brand new, so always prepared for a new class, right? What's that? Looks like some boring math stuff here. And says history. So yeah, I didn't really have a separate notebook for each class. There's everything mixed up in here, but I don't know if this is art or... Yeah, it's better you have a separate notebook for each class. It gets confusing if you mix everything in one. Okay, but let's move on. Schule. School. Ich gehe jeden Werktag zur Schule. I go to school every weekday. Yeah, that's what I did from Monday to Friday. Every weekday or workday I went to school. I've heard when my parents were young they even had to go to school on Saturday. That must have been awful times. So enjoy your living in the here now. Next one. Studieren. To study. Ich studiere Betriebswirtschaft. I study business management. Yeah, very cliche. Whenever you don't know what to study, study business management. Like, I studied business engineering a little bit different, but still, I wasn't sure what should I choose, so business always works. Well, if you're more of a creative type, you should probably choose something else. It's a lot about numbers, really. Next one. Es ist der erste Schultag. It's the first day of class. Yeah, some people love it, most people hate it. Like right now, it's summer break here. My little sister, she's 14, still going to school, being on holiday, of course. She's already super sad thinking of the first day of classes. Other people are just like very happy to see all their classmates again. As I said earlier, that's the coolest thing. You can see all your classmates again. So don't be too sad when it's first day of class. Of course, holiday is nice, but it's also cool to be around your friends all the time. Wir sind in derselben Klasse. We're in the same class. That's like, you can imagine this, right? You're going to school, like there are new classes. You want to know, oh, am I with my best friend in class? You look at the board and then, oh, it's me here. And then my best friend right next to me. Same class. Woo, woo, we're in the same class. Yeah, that's how I imagine the school kids to be happy about being in the same class with their friends. Woo, same class, yay. Was ist dein Hauptfach? What's your major? Yeah, going to college, probably this is the most asked question. It's first, what's your name, and then, what's your major? I think some people even would ask, what's your major, before asking, what's your name? So, be prepared to know the sentence, to know the answer for the sentence. You'll be asked this very often. Ich bin ganz Ihrer Meinung. I couldn't agree more with you. Apparently, a very strong expression for agreeing. In an argument, I don't know, it could be used at work or family, friends. For any group of people, you could use this, and there's a debate, and you really strongly agree with one side, then you totally can go for this. Ich bin ganz Ihrer Meinung. I couldn't agree more with you. If you're not as certain, and here we come for number two. Nun, ich bin nicht sicher. Well, I'm not sure. This is a way you kind of neither agree nor disagree. It's something in between. If you really don't know what's right, what's wrong, you could use this. It leaves it open, so... Yeah, even if people ask you something in German, maybe, and you're not sure how to answer because you maybe also didn't fully understand the question, go for, ich bin nicht sicher, I'm not sure, then at least you don't make a wrong decision you might regret later, right? Number three, easy one, natürlich, of course. So, for example, if I ask you, do you like learning German with German Pop 101? Your answer would be, natürlich, of course. Number four. Ich denke schon. I guess so. I would agree, but I'm not 100% sure. It's you're leaning towards one side, but don't want to fully fall out of it, right? Ja, Sie haben recht. Yes, you're right. The way I imagine it, of course, is like if you're in a dispute maybe with somebody and then you want to admit, okay, he's right for a thing, but then also bring on your own arguments or points. You can say, yes, you're right with this. Ja, Sie haben recht. But, and then put your own point. As easy as that.
Want to speed up your language learning? Take your very first lesson with us. You'll start speaking in minutes and master real conversations. Sign up for your free lifetime account. Just click the link in the description.